It's easy to make project parts that are square or rectangular and get them all to be equal. But when you're dealing with a project that has curved or irregular parts, such as the ends on this magazine rack, or the photo cutouts on this keepsake box, using a template and a router, you can make as many of these parts as you want and they'll all match perfectly. There's a couple different ways you can do template routing. The first way is to use a straight router bit and a guide bushing. The problem with this is, because the diameter of the guide bushing is larger than the diameter of the bit, your template can't be the same size as your finished project. That means if you want to make a template to route this box lid, you need to make it just a little smaller for the outside perimeter and the rounded corners to account for the offset between the guide bushing and the router bit. But for the photo cutouts, you need to make the holes just a little bit larger for the template. It can be kind of confusing. That's why I like to use bearing guided bits. The first type is called a flush trim bit. And you stick this in your router, then rest your router on top of your workpiece. The bearing in the bit rides against your template, and then as you cut along, it cuts flush with the template. The second type is a pattern bit, which works opposite in that the router rides on top of the template, the bearing rides against the template as the router cuts the workpiece. The nice thing about bearing guided bits is that the template is the exact same size as your project part. Now let's take a look at how to make the template. You can make a template out of almost anything. I prefer to make templates out of MDF, hardboard, or Baltic birch plywood. I'd steer clear of hardwoods because the seasonal changes in humidity can cause your boards to warp or twist or change a little bit so that your pattern pieces wouldn't turn out the same.
Take your pattern from the magazine or the pattern you've created yourself and adhere it to your template blank using spray adhesive.
Now cut to within about a 1/16 of an inch of the line using a bandsaw, scroll saw, or a jigsaw, and then sand it smooth to the line.
Once you've completed your template, apply double-faced tape to the template and adhere it to your workpiece. Be sure to press the template down firmly to ensure good adhesion. To save a step, I like to cut out the workpiece with the template in place, leaving about 1/8 inch around the template. Of course, there is a possibility of cutting into your template, so if you're not comfortable with that, then simply trace the template onto the blank and cut close to the pencil line.
Now we're ready to trim our workpiece to its final size using a flush trim bit on the router table. You can do this with a handheld router, but I prefer using a router table because you don't have to mess with clamps and you've got a lot more work surface to support your piece. I've installed a flush trim bit in a router table, set so the cutter height is just above the height of the workpiece and the bearing rides on the template. And I've installed a starter pin because this is a freehand cut. Now separate your workpiece from the template, and then attach the template to another new workpiece to route an identical matching one to this one. And for more information about routing with templates, go to woodmagazine.com.